All right, in this video, we're going to learn how to measure the angular diameters of planets and also dwarf planets from images that you've acquired with Skynet. So I'm going to share my screen. Okay, so we're looking at Afterglow, and I've already loaded in two images, one of Jupiter and one of Saturn. Now remember, when you first load the image in, the brightness and contrast is set to the default preset. And planets are really bright. So that means under the default preset, they're going to be saturated. I'm going to zoom in here. You can see it's a large saturation region. We don't want to measure the angular diameter of that. The planet's in there somewhere. So the first thing you have to do is change the brightness and contrast from default to bright target. So there it is. And zoom in a little bit more, make it nice and big, fill your viewer screen. And now we're going to measure the angular diameter. So to do that, come over here to the right, and it's the plotter tool. It's the one with the ruler icon. Click on that. And there are a number of things here, and we'll learn how to use some of these in a later lab. Right now, just check and make sure that they're all turned off. We don't want any of them on right now. Okay, so to measure the angular diameter, first you go off to one side and you find the edge. And where the edge is isn't 100% clear. You know, it's getting darker and darker. There are different shades of gray, and you have to just use your best judgment. It's not going to be a perfect measurement. But to my eye, the edge is somewhere around there. Then I go to the other side. Again, I careful and try to find the edge, and I click again. Now you can make this measurement along the equator or from pole to pole or on the diagonal as I've done. Totally up to you. It doesn't really make that big of a difference. And then come down here. It's currently listed under separation, though I'm probably going to change that to length, as in the length of the ruler. And we have three different units here. We have the size that we've measured, the angular diameter in pixels, in arc seconds, and arc minutes. And for planets, the angular diameters of planets, arc seconds are a good unit. And I measure 34.106 arc seconds. And that's more decimal places than you need. We can just call that 34.1 arc seconds. And that's the angular diameter. Of course, that's the angular diameter for the image I took. Sometimes Jupiter's closer, sometimes it's farther away, and so you will get a different value. Okay, let's do one more. Go over to my image of Saturn, and again, the brightness and contrast is set to default, so we're going to have to come back up to the display tool and change the brightness and contrast preset to bright target. So there's Saturn. Zoom in nice and big. Then back down to the plotter tool. And in the case of Saturn, we're not going to measure the angular diameter of the planet, but of the ring system. So go to one side of the rings, and best you can, find the edge. And then off to the other side, best you can, find the edge. Of course, it's not going to be perfect, because it's not perfectly clear what shade of gray actually is the edge. But that's something you can talk about in your sources of error. And be sure to measure the rings longwise, going across, not shortwise. Then come on down here, and in arc seconds, I measured 37.725 arc seconds, or to the nearest tenth, 37.7 arc seconds. Again, in your image, you'll measure a slightly different size, because sometimes Saturn's closer, sometimes it's farther away. All right, that's it for this video.